Welcome, everyone, to Prom Frolic 2019. Let me tell you, you are going to see a great show tonight. God has truly blessed Fox Valley with some amazing talent, and it's going to be up on this stage all night. But before we get to that talent, God has also blessed a lot of people with talents that they use behind the scenes. So I'd like to take a moment real quick, if you could put your hands together. First of all, I work with an amazing student council led by Emily Lillo as our president. Can we thank student council for all the work that they do for this? Next, we have a fantastic communications program, and Mrs. Ragnar and Mrs. Kalel did a ton of work to put these together. These are fantastic, so can we thank them, please? Now, that being said, they're amazing. I'm kind of a moron sometimes, and so I forgot that when we rehearsed, we switched some order. So your programs are going to be a little bit wrong at the beginning. Some of the, yeah, I'm sorry. It's my fault. Bring the booze. It's for me. There you go. I promise I'll do better next time. But there will be a few of the acts next time. Senior, sorry, that's nothing to you, right? You'll just have to go along with us for a little bit. The MC's got the right order. The acts know the right order, but it may be wrong in here, so that is my apologies. Finally, there are some really, really talented people who make this night possible. Mr. Nolte and Ms. Stern and the sound and light crew, the backstage, they are absolutely amazing. Can we say thank you to them? This couldn't happen without them. Obviously, it's our God who gives so much talent, so many blessings to this school, to FEL. And so we're going to start with a word of prayer, thanking God. And we asked a very special friend of ours to come and say the prayer for us tonight. So here you go.
Ask you for anything in particular, but rather we thank you for all the blessings that you have given us. Some of those blessings we are going to be able to see this evening. The performers and the DJs and the musicians and the music and sound and light people, we thank you for those people. We also thank you for your parents that they are here to listen to them. We thank you for the students that are here this evening. And we especially thank you, Lord, for sending your son, Jesus, to die for us, to be our Savior. We have, help us have a blessed evening, and all God's people say, Amen. Enjoy the evening.
Willie, hey Willie, are you interested at all? for Frolic.
All right, sure.
Okay. Three more guys. I gotta find three more guys.
Hey, guys. Great question for you. I need three more guys to be MCs for Frolic. You guys in?
Yeah.
I only got a spot for three.
I'm not gonna let one of you guys.
I already got one, guys. I'm sorry. I just need three this time.
No, we're good.
All right, I'll find someone else.
All right. Good luck.
Thanks. Hey, guys. You guys interested at all in being MCs for all
MCs for all the seniors.
Yeah, but I really need some guys right now.
Let's do it.
All right, thanks.
Hey, guys. Did you see who the new MCs are going to be?
No.
It's going to be juniors.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Ooh.
It's never juniors.
It's all seniors.
It's Chris, Isaiah,
why?
Garrett.
Isaiah?
Well, at least I got one more in the group.
That's true. So, how did this even happen?
I don't know.
Guys, you have to do something about this.
It's never juniors. We have to do something.
It's going downhill real fast. We don't change something.
Guys, only we can like go back in time and change it.
Only we can just say yes.
Guys, I actually know somebody who's been working on something for a while. It's pretty awesome. We could actually go back in time, I think.
I like it. Hey, who else is
there? Hey, let's go. The MCs, let's go. MCs on 3, 1, 2, 3.
MCs!
Just what you're searching for right here.
We need a time machine, not a cloning machine.
Take this. It's your only key to getting back from the past. It's also the only way you can communicate from the past with me. Now remember, with great power comes great responsibility, and try not to mess up the space-time continuum too much.
All right, who's going first? I have things first, let's go.
Go ahead.
Oh, boys, try to be careful. This is the first time I've ever really tried something like this.
What?
Well, later.
No.
I didn't expect that to work. All right.
Caleb shouldn't be working on the time machine.
We can always get food.
you guys are going to have to say bye to Doc and Marty, because I'm taking you back to the future.
Oh, here we go. Prom Frog 2019, who's ready? Oh, come on, we can do better than that. I just joined chat. I said, who's ready? All right, now before we start, I say a couple thank yous. That intro video was done here by my good friend, Micah Thiesfeld. Let's give it up. He did a great job. We'll see you in a little bit, Micah. And also, I want to say a huge thanks to Mr. U for trusting us with these mics, especially Willie and me. Hopefully, he doesn't regret that. And now it's time. You guys been waiting for it. To introduce your 2019 Prom Corps, let's hear it.
Cue music, please. Up first, we have Peyton Dahlke with his escort, Jenna Sharon. Next up, we have Caleb Hahnman with his escort, Crystal Zessen. Next up, we have Adam Labs and his escort, Hannah Bartman. Up next, we have Micah Thiesfeld and his escort, Eddie Siegelstrom. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2019 Prom Corps, let's hear it.
All right, so you guys remember the Beastie Boys, right? Probably one of our favorite acts. Well, guess what? They came back bigger and better than ever before. Up first, we have the Laundry Guys performing Sabotage. Let's hear it from you guys. Let's go. First act of the night.
I'ma stand straight this water gate, but I can't stand rocking when I'm in here. Cause your crystal ball ain't so crystal clear. So why you sit back and wonder why I got this massive thorn in my side? Oh my god, it's a mirage. I'm telling y'all it's sabotage. So listen up, cause it can't say nothing. You shut me down with a push of your button, but yo, I'm out and I'm gone. I tell you now, I keep it on and on. What you see you might not get, and we can bet. So don't you get soup jet scheming on a thing that's a mirage. Trying to tell you now it's sabotage. Y'all, it's a sabotage. Listen, all y'all, it's a sabotage. Listen, all y'all, it's a sabotage. Listen, all y'all, it's a... I can't stand it. I know you planned it. I'ma stand straight this water cage, but I can't stand rocking when I'm in this place, cause I feel disgrace when you're all in my face. So make no mistake and switch up my channel. I'm Buddy Rich when I fly off the handle. We're gonna be, it's a mirage, scheming on a thing that's sabotage.
Check.
Testing.
I got it.
All right, let's. Can you hear me? All right. All right, let's hear it for the Laundry Boys one more time! All right, we've got some good stuff going so far. Right now, we're going to get a little teacher trivia going. All right. Our first teacher shot their brother in the eye with a BB gun. Who shot their brother in the eye with a BB gun?
Mr. Zunker.
It's not Mr. Zunker. Jaden? All right, Jacob, you got one.
Mr. Shireen.
It's not Mr. Shireen.
Pastor Krause.
It's not Pastor Krause. One more.
Coach Fry.
It was Coach Fry! Get that man some candy. All right, up next we have Crystal Zessen, Dominic Bay, Brady Workus, and Elizabeth Schultz singing Rewrite the Stars.
You know I want you, it's not a secret I try to hide. You know you want me, so don't keep saying our hands are tied. You claim it's on the cards, fate is pulling you miles away and out of reach from me. But you're here in my heart, so who can stop me if I decide that you're my destiny? What if we rewrite the stars? Say you were made to be mine. Nothing could keep us apart, 'cause you were the one I was meant to find. It's up to you, and it's up to me. No one can say what we get to be. So why don't we rewrite the stars? Maybe the world could be ours tonight.
You think it's easy
You think I don't wanna ride, but there are mountains and there are doors that we can walk through. I know you're wondering why, because we're able to be just you and me within these walls. But when we go outside, you're gonna wake up and see that it was hopeless after all. No one can rewrite the stars. How can you say you'll be mine? Everything keeps us apart, and I'm not the one you were meant to find. It's not up to you, it's not up to me. When everyone tells us what we can be, how could we rewrite the stars? Say that the world can be ours. Tonight, all I want is to fly with you. All I want is to fall with you. So just give me all of you. It feels impossible. Is it impossible? Say that it's possible. How can we rewrite the stars?
Say you were made to be mine.
Nothing could keep us apart, 'cause you are the one I was meant to find. It's up to you, and it's up to me. No one can say what we get to be. Why don't we rewrite the stars, changing the world to be ours? You know I want you. It's not a secret I've tried to hide. I know you want me. We're bound to break and our hands are tied.
Okay, okay, guys. Just because you stand up and laugh doesn't make it stand-up comedy. Leave it to Caleb, the real stand-up comedian.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, I'm going to be performing for you a little bit of stand-up comedy. So if you choose to, feel free to laugh, clap, join in a little bit. And if you choose not to, well, God is watching. For those of you who don't recognize me, my name is Caleb Hahnemann. I'm a little bit of a theater kid here at FBL, so you may have seen me on stage or avoided me in the hallways. A little bit more about me. I'm a senior this year, so as a senior, I kind of feel obligated to spill some tea, maybe let you in on a couple of senior secrets. So, all right. I can do that. So a little bit of a secret. For all you incoming freshmen, underclassmen, you've got nothing to worry about. I'm just about as clueless as you are, to be honest. No, seriously, think about this. That's really all a senior is, right? Is a freshman that knows they're an idiot. Like, for example, I was always the kind of kid who got a lot of question marks on my quizzes, tests, stuff like that. You guys have seen this before, yet where a teacher will write in that, like, question mark next to your work. Like, great, thanks, I also have no idea what I'm doing here. It's good to see we're on the same page. Because I've never picked up on a lot of the same stuff that other seniors have. I just feel dumb and clueless. I'm still not sure if we have a pool. Also, Rev and Pastor Wenz, they look too much alike. I don't know who to believe anymore, seriously. Okay, another thing that just rubbed me the wrong way that I never really got. I never understood the whole homecoming promposal ask out thing. It just never made any sense to me, because you wouldn't use that to ask anyone else out to anything else, right? Would you like to go to Applebee's with me? Hashtag endless apps 2K19. But you really can't blame me for being this dumb, right? Because FVL has changed so much since I was a freshman. It's a completely different school now. Like, remember when school started at 8 a.m., right? My thoughts exactly. Well, now it starts at 7:55. So they add 5 minutes to each day. That way we can make up for spending 20 or so minutes complaining about it. Okay, the real reason behind that, they did that for snow days though, right? I have to admit, it's a good purpose. Well then how come I still had to trudge through snow deeper than some of the things Mr. Bent says? That's the real anathema. Another change here at FVL, the classes. They've changed so much. It's a completely different class landscape out there. Like, I used to breeze through my classes freshman year. I was a decent student. And now I'm getting daily quizzes with questions like, Hamlet contemplated his own mortality. What was his favorite flavor of Takis? And, like, I've even changed since freshman year. Like, I used to keep my locker spick and span, as clean as possible. And now it's about as messy as every other aspect of my life. Now, finally, I'd like to address maybe the most important change to me. Upperclassmen, I believe you'll agree with me here. It's a change in the cafeteria. Specifically a dessert food. You probably know what I'm talking about. Two deliciously moist cookies sandwiching sweet cream with sprinkles on it. It was delicious. You could feel your arteries harden with every bite. But one day, they just ripped them away from us. Why? Well, I'm enlisting all of you. I need your help to get them back, even just for a day, just once. I need your help. I say this because I tried to do it myself, Lord knows. I tried to submit a comment card, you know, in the comment box over on the right side of the cafeteria. You know, comment box over there where you throw your forks away, right? Well, I tried to submit a comment card, and I got it back. And all they did is next to what I wrote, they wrote in a question mark. Thank you very much, FEL. You've been a fantastic audience. Thank you. Please enjoy the rest of Frolic.
Check. Atta boy, Caleb, you killed it out there.
Howdy, partner!
Howdy, partner. It's time to whip out our cowboy hats for this one.
Next up, we have the Horse Gang giving us a little country remix.
Yeehaw!
the horses.
People with a pedometer race, please come to the backstage right now. The pedometer race. Next up, we have Taylor Van Handel and Lena Honke singing Whenever You Remember.
Touch the sky whenever you remember.
I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, we claim the bright star and we came so far. You know that we showed them all. No, we won't forget. Yeah. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us. We believe that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, ooh, whenever you.
All right, guys, next up we got a little game brewing here. We've got a representative from each class. This game is called the Bobblehead Face-Off. So basically we have pedometers, which for those of you who don't know, it tracks your steps. And our contestants up here are gonna each have 30 seconds to bobble their head as many times as they can. And the winner at the end with the most steps is going to get a piece of candy. So each class has got to be cheering for their person. Josiah also wanted me to mention that he has his hype man, Chris Party Wild, out here. So 30 seconds. All right, so you guys have 30 seconds to show us your bobblehead skills.
3, 2, 1, go!
Shake your head, not your body!
Shake it, Harris!
Hey, you know what kind of 10 seconds!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
stop! Don't move! We'll read the freshmen's off first. Christian started off the night with 78 for the freshman.
Josiah Bain for the juniors, 103.
All right, for the sophomores, we have 74.
And Paris Bame, 72. Juniors win. Yeah. Next up, stage is going to be rocked again. This time, we got the Goofy Goobers.
Thank you.
You know what, Plankton? You're right. I am just a kid. And I've been through a lot in the past 6 days, 5 minutes, 20 and a half seconds. And if there's something that I've learned in that time, it's that you are who you are. And no amount of mermaid magic or managerial promotions or some other third thing can change me from what I really am inside, a kid. But that's okay, because I did what everyone said a kid couldn't do. I made it to Shell City, and I beat the Cyclops, and I rode the Hasselhoff, and I brought the crown back. So yeah, I'm a kid, and I'm also a goofball, and a wingnut, and a knucklehead mixed Bazitron. But most of all, I'm a Goofy Goober! Go Goofy Goober! Goofy Goobers! Goofy, Goofy, Goofy Goober! Put your toys away! But then I gotta say, when you tell me not to place in the way! No, 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 no way! I'm a kid, you say. When you say I'm a kid, I say it again. And then I say thanks. Thank you very much. So if you're thinking that you'd like to be like me, go ahead, try and get inside, we'll see you. I'm a little bibbly, simmily bibbly, I'm a little bibbly, simmily bop. I'm a Goofy Goober. You're a Goofy Goober. We're all Goofy Goobers. Goofy, Goofy, Goofy Goober. I wanna rock, rock. I wanna rock, rock. I wanna rock, rock. I wanna rock, rock. Yeah! His chops are too righteous. The helmets can't handle this level of rock and roll.
That was a little goofy. Nice job, Goofy Goobers. Let's give it up for Jenna Sharon playing a little piano medley.
Cause we're all in the mood, car.
Alright guys, I know Jenna was really nervous, so could we just give her one more hand? She did awesome. Next up, we got a part of Frolic that doesn't really need an introduction, but we're gonna do it anyway. We got the top 10! Should I come back and get this, or what's next?
You can't do that!
There's already six people in the pits.
Who cares? Come on. Hey, there's seven of you. Who is number seven?
Hello.
Run.
Did you know what he had planned for today?
The 10-mile run.
Yeah, man.
Oh. I mean, we're tennis players. Like, yeah. It's not like we're a track or,
no.
Or baseball or golf.
That is true. Golf, man, that's such a sucky sport.
Hey, so, you do not have to practice.
No, you?
No. I was wondering, you want to go get something to eat?
Sure.
Oh, where?
The usual.
The usual.
person. The reading today comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. So whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. But make sure that when you're eating, it's something like eggs, packed with protein, vitamins, and meat. Get your good fats in there. Or you could go with vegetables. Vegetables are always good for you, right?
Our second reading comes from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 22. A cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. That is our reading for today. You would all stand for the bone song.
This is my cranium.
Juan 3:16. Porque tanto amó Dios al mundo que dio a su Hijo unigénito para que todo el que cree en él no se pierda, sino que tenga vida eterna. Continuamos con cantar Cristo me ama.
¡Aleluya!
Can't no further. I'm just too dumb to play.
going the top 10! Big shout out to Rav, he's a smooth guy. Alright. Jaden, so I've been looking for a comedy act. You know anybody?
Yeah, I think I know a guy.
Next up, we got Danny Plitt with his stand-up comedy, Noah.
That's a lot of people. Wow, that works. So I'm going to tell you guys a little story about a guy by the name of Noah. Everybody who knows Noah, he built an ark. You say, what, Noah, do you say? Well, he built an ark. But very few people know the first conversation that went on between the Lord and Noah. So Noah's in his wood shop one day, working, making a few things for the home there. He's a good carpenter, and voompa, 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 voompa.
Noah.
Somebody call?
Voompa, voompa, voompa. Noah.
Who is that?
It's the Lord, Noah.
Right. What do you want? I've been good.
I want you to build me an ark.
Right. What's an ark?
Get some wood, build it 300 cubits by 500 cubits by 30 cubits.
Right. What's a cubit?
A cubit, I used to know it. Don't worry about that, no. When you get that done, go out into the world and collect all of the animals in the world by twos, male and female, and put them into the ark.
Right. Who is this really? How come you want me to do all these strange things?
I'm going to destroy the world.
Right. How you gonna do it?
I'm gonna make it rain 4,000 days and drown them right out.
Right. Aha. Try this, you'll save water. Let it rain for 40 days and 40 nights and wait for the sewers to back up.
Right.
So we move a little bit further in the timeline, and Noah's built the ark and everything, and he's getting the animals, and Noah really had one heck of a job. I mean, collect all the animals in the world by twos. Two mosquitoes, male or female. And believe me, I wish he wouldn't have. So we find Noah pulling up the last two hippos, and he's really in a hurry because he's afraid the Lord's going to call and give him something else to do. I mean, this is one heck of a job for a man 600 years old. So he's pulling up the last two hippos, and sure enough, the Lord does call. Come on, come on, fat hippos, come on, come on.
Noah.
What? What do you want?
You gotta take one of those hippos out and bring in another one.
What for?
Because you got two males down there and you need to bring in a female.
I ain't bringing in nothing. You change one of them.
Oh, come on. You know I don't work like that.
Yeah, well, I got news for you. I'm sick and tired of this. I've been working on all day, working on for days and days. I'm sick and tired of this.
Noah?
Yeah?
How long can you tread water?
Yeah, well, I got news for you. I'm sick and tired of this. Whole neighborhood's out there laughing at me. They're all having a grand old time. And I got my best friend, Larry. I said, Larry, I've been talking to the Lord. Larry said, oh, really? I said, yeah, I've been talking to the Lord. Larry, Lord, Lord, Larry. You walked off laughing at me. They're all laughing at me, having a grand time. You know I'm the only guy in this neighborhood with an ark? I'm sick and tired of this. They're all walking around with picket signs saying, how's it going up there, Tarzan? How's it going? I'm sick and tired of this. You're supposed to know and see y'all. You let me go out there. You let me bring in a pregnant elephant. You never tell me the thing was pregnant or nothing. You didn't give me no manual for delivery. And there is good old Noah waiting underneath the elephant. And brum, right out on top of him. I'm sick and tired of this. You're supposed to know and see y'all, like I said. You let me go out there. You let me do all this stuff. You never even looked in the bottom of that ark. Have you looked down there? No! Who's going to clean up that mess down there? Not me, I'll tell you that. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'll tell you. I'm going to let all those animals out. Then I'm going to burn down that ark, and I'm moving to Florida because you haven't done nothing for me since. I'm sick and tired of this. And you got it raining. Me and you, Lord, this has always been me and you, right? Right, all the way, Lord, me and you, buddy, buddy. And you guys know the rest of the story, thank you guys.
Hey, G, really hungry right now. You got anything for me?
I mean, I do have this candy bar, but I was really looking forward to eating it, and I don't know, I don't really... Well, I can just give it to you. That's how much you mean to me.
Hey, next up we got Colin Krieger and Emma Nolte singing What You Mean to Me.
Sentence doesn't seem to make a difference. Nothing can explain just what you mean to me.
Every shape and all the colors, all the love from all the lovers, never could express just what you mean to me.
Every instinct, shape, every feeling,
every breathless, all my senses reeling, just what you mean to me.
What you mean to me.
6?
Sure.
5 and 6.
Yeah. Here.
All right, we got next up, we have Abby Parker giving us a little love for our area. Her song is called 920. Let's give it up.
Make some noise.
Some bent street signs, burned out car lights, tell our stories. They tell our stories. In this burned out town, let's burn it down and fade away. Fade far away. And my feet have hit the pavement, and we're sprung out in the basement. This is home. This is home. And maybe we'll grow out of this. Stop throwing all our same old fits. Whoa, oh, oh. Whoa, oh. Maybe we'll end up somewhere. The wind just blows right through our hair. Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, oh. And we'll walk downtown, and we'll wear a frown. Whoa, oh, oh. Whoa, oh. The same things over again, and maybe we'll escape our brains somehow, somehow. And maybe we'll grow out of this, maybe it's all just for kicks. Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, oh. And maybe we'll end up somewhere.
All right, we're going to get the baby pictures rolling here in a second so we can get the screen coming down. But first, we're going to do a little more teacher trivia.
All right, this teacher won a cow milking contest against the town mayor.
Anybody? I think we got one. Oh boy, I got to get around.
Hey, I got one right here.
Oh, shoot.
Mr. Lemke.
Mr. Lemke. Lemke.
That is incorrect.
We got another answer over here.
Mr. Benz.
That is incorrect.
Mark J. Krause.
Nope. It's a female teacher.
Miss Polly.
No. Last one.
Miss Stern.
That is incorrect.
We got another one.
Mrs. Mears.
Yeah, let's get it! Yeah. Love you, Mama. Let's roll the Bay Pictures. Let's get it.
Thank you. kissed your head. Said I was just like you.
say, just go and say.
Okay.
Oh, Steve. All right, it's time to get a little groovy. We got an 80s dance from our seniors. Make some noise.
We got here, got a plate of spaghetti, cup of water. Each team has to finish both of them in order to win. People in the garbage bags can't use their arms. They need to rely on their partner in the back to feed them. And the person in the bag is going to be blindfolded.
Huh? Get the other blindfold. Tom, we're in for a second blindfold.
All right, we're waiting on a second blindfold. Here we are.
Make sure it's close enough.
I got a
lead.
Hey, all right.
Here.
Wait, I can't see. I can't see.
The water's in front.
Okay.
Where's the plate?
Down.
Here we go, right here.
Oh.
Here we go. The water's in front.
Ready, set, go. Twenty seconds left. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Hey, let's hear it for Steve, the winner. And also, Aaron. Thank you both for coming up here and participating.
Well, that was messy. So next up, we have a little Queen medley going on from the band King.
Thank you.
As many of you probably know, I'm a big fan of Freddie Mercury. Thank you. And anyway, he had these traditions at his show where he'd get a little crowd participation going. So I'm going to ask you to do is sing what I sing. It's not hard, and please do it, or it's going to be really awkward.
All right, guys. Well, Jaden, how you been enjoying Frolic so far, you know?
Oh, it's pretty great. How about you?
Oh, I like it. What'd you guys have for breakfast this morning?
Ooh, I had a Pop-Tart.
It was Pop-Tart. Nice. What'd you get?
I had some waffles.
Hey, guys. Quit it with the small talk. We'll leave that to Brianna, Tommy, and Joan back here singing Little Talks.
Thank you.
dear. The stairs creak as I sleep, it's keeping me awake. It's the house telling you to close your eyes. Some days I can't even trust myself. It's killing me to see you this way. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Don't listen to a word I say. Hey, the screams all sound the same. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. There's an old voice in my head that's holding me back. Well, tell her that I miss our little talks. There's a old voice in my head that's holding me back. We used to play outside when we were young and full of life and full of love. Some days I don't know if I am wrong or right. Your mind is playing tricks on you, my dear. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Don't listen to a word I say. Hey, the screams all sound the same. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Now you're gone, gone, gone away. I watched you disappear. All that's left is a ghost of you. Now we're torn, torn, torn apart. There's nothing we can do. Just let me go, we'll meet again soon. Now wait, wait, wait for me. Please hang around. I'll see you when I fall asleep. Don't listen to a word I say. Hey, the screams all sound the same. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Don't listen to a word I say. Hey, the screams all sound the same. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our body safe to shore. 'Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our body safe to shore.
All right, guys, so I don't know if you can remember back to Homecoming Frolic, but we actually celebrated a very special person's birthday. And actually, it just so happened, coincidence, tonight is actually his birthday as well.
Where are you, Blobe? Blobe, get up
here. Get up here, Ryan Blobe!
Come on, bud. Happy birthday. Birthday boy, once again.
Now, the birthday boy deserves a little song from us. We got a cupcake here for him. He's so special to us. We're going to sing to him, all right? Three, two, one.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And capping off the night, we have our last group called Dengroove.
Let's go, boys.
Thank you.
Nice job, guys. So, I don't know if you guys know it, but behind the curtain, there's a lot of magic going on.
I just want to join with me and say huge thanks to Isaiah Thurn and Brady Johnson. They're the ones communicating.
Keep it up. Awesome job.
All right, now it's time to introduce or to bring back the 2019 Prom Corps. Let's hear it.
Presented by Emily Willow, our student body president.
Up first, we have Peyton Nalke with his escort, Jenna Sharon. Next up, Caleb Hahnman with his escort, Crystal Dawson. Felt and his escort, Eddie Siegelstrom. Prom Court. Drive safely. Have a good night, everybody.
Take care. Woo! See ya.